So, I'm 7 episodes in, and I think I've worked out most of the kinks. So it looks like it's time for my first ever miniature series! I wish there was a way to shorten that. So what do I have that I can serialize? No. 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 Oh, cool. Perfect. This is Brand New Relic, the monthly series where I finally play the classic games I never got to try. Yes, I'm kicking off my first 3-part episode by tackling all of the previous generations of PlayStation. I completely missed out on this best-selling franchise of consoles growing up, so for the next 3 months, I'll be playing a flagship game from each of the first 3 generations of PlayStation. And if there's one genre I kept hearing about when it came to PlayStation 1, it was the adventure game. So spoilers ahead for Tomb Raider. No, not that one. Or that one. Or that one, that was a thing? There it is. Yes, gaming characters typically don't become household names overnight, and that was especially true in the 1990s. Heck, you could have an entire legacy and people wouldn't know who you were. But Lara Croft became an instant sensation, selling 7 million copies, gracing magazine covers, and spawning the movies Tomb Raider, Lara Croft Tomb Raider, and Lara Croft Tib Rare the E of Life. There are a number of sequels, remakes, and spin-offs, but it all started with this one game on the original PlayStation. Yes, and the Sega Saturn, you also had the game. Well done. Now back to the bottom of the screen with you. There you go. Lara Croft came about during the time of the Rosie O'Donnell Show, platform sandals, and Sixpence None the Richer. It was an innocent time. She turns 25 this year, or technically 53, so let's see if this first adventure holds up a quarter of a century later. So believe it or not, I actually played a bit of this game when it first came out. Yes, I played a game. Back in my teenage years, I rented a PlayStation from Hastings. Rest in peace, Hastings. You were the finest purveyor of movies, music, books, and games that Northern Idaho had to offer.
You gave me a shoulder when I needed it.
And with the PlayStation, I rented 3 games: the Die Hard Trilogy, Resident Evil, and yes, Tomb Raider. But because the rental didn't come with a memory card, I could only get so far, and every time I turned it off, I had to start all over again.
Aww.
I know, I've had it so hard. So I understand the general tone of the game, especially having played the 3 titles in the rebooted series, but now I have the PlayStation, I have the memory card, and honestly none of that matters because I'm playing it on the PlayStation 3 that my friend James very kindly donated. Ooh, love a 90s CGI intro. And Indiana Jones goes flying by in a fridge. We see Sephiroth from Final Fantasy VII, and then we meet Lara Croft, who's so famous that she's on the cover of Disney Adventures magazine. We get FaceTime about 15 years early, and the head of Natla Industries asks Lara Croft to go to Peru to recover an ancient artifact called the Scion. But first, it's time for a tutorial. And what better place than Lara's home? After looking at her senior yearbook photo, we're in her... Lara, you have guests. Mind putting on a shirt? We practice tumbling in her music room, obviously, complete with a piano that only has 32 keys. Ooh, is that an original Surratt? And wow, these controls are gonna take some getting used to. You know how nowadays you look with the right stick and move with the left? Well, look at this thing. No sticks! No sticks! So you have to move with the D-pad and look by holding down a shoulder button while moving the D-pad. It's... not great.
Run up to a crate, and while still pressing forward, press action, and I'll vault up onto it.
Who's the voice of Lara Croft? Shelley Blonde. Ironic name for a brunette.
Oh, air.
And so far, Tomb Raider is a game about a financially stable, comfortably dressed person relaxing in a pool. I love it! Indie game of the year! But now it's time for the adventure proper. I'm on a mountain with...
this random guy!
I use the least stable grappling hook to scale this temple when... Lara, why are you wearing shorts in the snow? I kill some of Jacob Black's family before entering the caves, where I'm already hitting Indiana Jones-style obstacles. And wow, what thrilling music! I find a bridge to nowhere, and already this game is more than I can bear. Lara can jump ridiculously high, and hey, I'm at the end of the level already, that was easy. And the game tracks my kills, items, secrets, and time? Where have I seen that before?
Oh, right.
So then I go for a lovely swim and... Okay, let me try that again. And not cool sneaking up on me, Wolf! Hashtag Team Edward! I'm trying to explore, but it's really not paying off for me. But I figured out how to push a box. And pull it. And it only takes forever to do so. Though to be fair, I probably couldn't do this in real life, so good on you, Lara. And I know this is an ancient cave, but they should really get someone in here to fix the floors. And I just realized she can do the time warp.
It's just a jump to the left.
I spend a long time flipping switches and opening doors, only to die on this one axe swing. Bad design, game. So now I have to go all the way back and redo all of this work because they didn't put a save spot in... Oh, I missed that the first time. Okay, that's on me. But I can save, which is good, in case I... do that.
Shh, he's sleeping.
And wait, there are dinosaurs in this?
We have a T-Rex.
Turns out I'm in a level called Lost Valley, which is appropriate because I don't know where to go. But I do have a compass, which... doesn't do much. I have to collect a series of cogs, which is difficult when they blend right into the floor texture. And it turns out, when you find a secret, it sounds like a film noir.
You know how to whistle, don't you, Steve? You just put your lips together and blow.
And yeah, when it comes to outrunning boulders, I'm clearly not Indiana Jones. And yes, I know I keep referencing Indiana Jones, but to be fair, so does this game. Except he never landed on spikes. Wait, no. Wow, that was lucky. Also, I'd like to see Harrison Ford try to do this. I get a shotgun and take on a mummy, which actually wasn't harming me, so I don't know why I killed it. But did I kill it? Can you kill a mummy? I don't know how this works. I get the artifact and cool, game's done, that was easy. Then I make my way to... a human?
You and that driveling piece of the Skion, you want to keep it so bad?
Who's apparently Sawyer from Lost? Turns out I only have a piece of the artifact, and Natla sent someone else to get the other pieces. I thank Sawyer for that info by kicking him in the face. So I leave Peru and... Is this where the Matrix got its elevator riding idea? Do they teach that in archaeology school? After taking some me time to catch up with a good book, Lara heads to Greece to meet up with Pierre DuPont. Of the Delaware DuPonts? But it looks like Pierre got there first.
Pierre, you litterbug.
So now we're fighting lions and gators and... Well, we already fought bears. Oh my. I make some really dumb mistakes, and then sneak my way past a room of lightning, and I think I'm finally getting the hang of... I'm crushed. And isn't this music better suited to plate spinning? I try to open this door, but...
No.
Wow, Lara. Rude. Rude, Lara. Rude. And with these wonky controls, paired with precariously designed levels, I keep running into the situation where one misplaced button press leads to game over. Though sometimes it works in my favor, like jumping over the boulder here. I ran out of save spots in this giant level, so along with dodging this boulder, I need to make sure I don't drown, carefully walk through this terrifying room filled with falling swords, and make my way to the bottom without doing anything stupid, so I have to be very... You know, I don't think I like this game very much. And on top of that, I keep meeting up with Pierre, and it may just be me, but I think there are sparks between us. Or is that bullets? I think that's bullets. Aw, what a cute pool! Then I come across these two lions who are just chilling. They're not attacking me, they can't be shot, they're just... kicking it.
Can you feel the love tonight?
And then, I reach this jumping section. I fall in the water, so I try again. And I fall in the water, so I try again, and again, and again. After 38 minutes and 64 attempts, I finally make it to the other end. And my only reward is a bar of lead. So... worth it? So now I'm at Midas, which is great because now I can get my muffler fixed. And that's what I get for being greedy. Turns out I used the Midas touch to turn my lead bars to gold, because Lara isn't rich enough, apparently. Oh, but I have to give away my gold. Are you listening, Bezos? And then I spent 2 hours on this one level? What is this, Dark Souls? I assume I've never played it. Then I spend a long amount of time pulling out this box, only to realize I should have been pushing it.
Push it real good!
And then look who's back!
Pierre, you shouldn't have come!
Ooh, darts, how fun! I'm not very good at the game myself. Or this game, for that matter. And dang, check out Katie Ledecky over here. I die right before a save point, so that's fun. What a fun game. I pick up some very oversized keys, and ooh, a medipack, how convenient. A little too convenient. Oh, yeah, I see you, Boulder's not gonna trick me into dying this time.
A little late for the prize giving.
I take down Gerard Depardieu over here, and these guns have a nice rhythm.
To Hoken, one of the two just rulers of Atlantis.
Wow, and that's without Google Translate. Then this happens. Okay. And then, oh, hey, I always wanted to see this in person.
And if we have the time, we could see the Sphinx!
Isn't Sapphire spelled with two P's? I make my way to a gun! Don't scare me like that, mummy dog! And good, there's a safe spot. I'm just gonna take care of these panthers before... Wait, no! For the record, if I wasn't playing this for the episode, I would have turned this off long ago. Fortunately, covering all this ground has made me an expert at these controls. Except for grabbing this ledge, and then I... What was that? That was amazing! Okay, that's all I'm pulling myself up every time from now on. Wow, what a super tall corpse. It's also great that this ancient structure has a place to sit and have a nice chat, which it looks like Lara could use because she seems pretty upset. And then, what are those? No, seriously, what are these things? You know, just a normal day, taking on a centaur that shoots fireballs, no big. I take care of Sawyer from Lost again, only to be captured by Natla. Turns out the head of a corporation who sends multiple people to pilfer priceless artifacts from indigenous tribes and pits them against each other is actually rather evil. Who knew? Multiple people to pilfer priceless artifacts. Multiple people to pilfer priceless artifacts. That's my new tongue twister. But Lara escapes and... Is no one on the boat seeing this? She climbs on board and... Yeah, she's earned a nap. So now I'm in the mines and...
I'm on a boat!
Wait, I can't ride the minecart? But I want to go all Temple of Doom! I find the switch to pull it out and... I still can't ride it? 1 out of 5, F+, donate it. Then all these boxes make me think I'm in that maze screensaver from Windows 95. And ooh, a building being suspended from the ceiling isn't something you see every day. I break the building, lowering its property value, and get my pistols? Wait, were my weapons gone? Good to know, I guess. So now I take on a cowboy.
Ain't nothing personal.
Oh great, well, as long as it's not personal. And then, wait, didn't I already play Doom? I try to navigate around the lava and... Well, that feels accurate. But I somehow don't burn on the lava as I rub up against it.
From my point of view, the Jedi are evil!
And then TNT, oh good. Except shooting at it doesn't do anything. And then we take on Tony Hawk, bypass some more dumb boulder traps, push a bunch of boxes in the worst puzzle ever, and that's what you get for holding my arms that one time. And then Natla does a thing. That does another thing. Could someone turn on the lights? Thank you. There are a bunch of eggs.
Get away from her, you bitch!
And then we've wandered into Silent Hill 2. Ugh, that's a long way down. Fortunately, there's a safe spot just past this... So then I meet a fleshy doppelganger who mimics my every movement in a kind of Harpo Marx-style routine. Video games, everybody. This kind of biological discovery could mean worlds for the... Oh, okay, or I could just burn it. So it turns out Natla was one of the rulers of Atlantis, but got demoted.
He chose... poorly.
We confront Natla and...
Too late for abortions now.
Yikes. So then we face off against this monster and... Okay, that one's on me. So then after a multitude of precarious insta-death traps and another one of those stupid jumping sections, I destroy the Scion for... reasons. Before being faced with a leap of faith. It worked for Indiana Jones, so here we go! No, fine. I'm so close to the end. I get it on my second try, and then I face off against Natla, who's sporting her best Halloween look. I take her down, but there's still lots of precarious jumping and climbing, because of course there is. But I finally escape, just as this magnificent ancient structure is destroyed. And then we get to the end credits, which... Oh, I guess the credits are over. Only 6 people were worth mentioning when creating this game, I guess. Anyway, whatever, I did it. I never have to play Tomb Raider again. Seriously, that took me almost 22 hours to get through. That's twice as much as Silent Hill. That's only slightly less than Earthbound. And with Final Fantasy VII... Well, no, nothing's been as long as Final Fantasy VII. But still. Don't get me wrong, I understand how influential Tomb Raider was in 1996. And for being a 3D game that relied entirely on D-pad controls, they really seemed to make controlling the game as player-friendly as they could. Lara automatically and mercifully aims at the nearest enemy, and the look button really comes in handy. And these levels are fun to look at. Some weird shifting textures aside, the locations are dynamic, and considering how mid-90s the graphics are, some of the scenes are gorgeous to look at and are filled with fun details. And for being a 90s PlayStation title, the voiceover work is actually pretty good, especially when compared to the competition.
You were almost a Jill sandwich.
You're right!
And apart from the outfit and, you know, that move, Lara is a badass protagonist who more than deserves the stardom she received. And that's about it for me. Which leads us to... Remember when I said that Earthbound was difficult to figure out without a guide? And remember when I said that Super Mario Galaxy 2 had imprecise controls? And remember when I said the visuals of Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic hadn't aged well? And remember when I said that Doom's levels were perhaps too massive? Well, I'd like to issue a formal apology to each of those games. Tomb Raider was rough. I understand that it's the best that could be done in 1996, but 25 years has not been kind. Starting with the lack of music, which just sucks a lot of the energy out of the game. The tank controls make it difficult to move Lara around a space, which is fine when navigating a large area, tedious when lots of climbing is involved, difficult when moving around in tight corners, and downright ridiculous when trying to do anything with a timer. It's especially frustrating when there's an enemy who's a lot faster and has more mobility than you do, which can lead to a super quick death. It made it easier to just wait in a hallway and slowly pick off the enemy one bullet at a time, which is less frustrating but not nearly as fun. Those controls also make it a whole ordeal to just pick up one item, provided you can even see it in the first place. On several occasions, items were a similar color to the ground they were on, making them almost invisible. And while the levels were fun to look at, they were much less fun to explore. Items are generally few and far between, and solutions to puzzles are often really difficult to find. Hiding necessary items behind secrets was already frustrating in Doom, and at least there you could move quickly and easily around the space. When the thing you need to progress is hidden behind a box that's just slightly darker than the others, that's bordering on ridiculous. Like I said, it took me over 20 hours to finish the game, and that was with a guide. Yes, even with a walkthrough, it still took me way too long to get to the end of this game. And that's because of my biggest issue, which is the brutal length between save spots. In the PC and Mac versions, apparently you can save at any point, which is great. But on the PlayStation, you can easily go 20 or 30 minutes between saves. And when pretty much everything can kill you in a matter of a few seconds, if not downright instantly, that's just punishing, and makes for a playthrough that was more anxiety-inducing than enjoyable. So yeah, if I weren't playing it for the episode, how long would I have gone before putting this one aside? Well... If this were 1996, I only had a handful of PlayStation games and a lot more time than I do now, I'd have probably played it all the way through. Tomb Raider helped write a lot of rules for the adventure genre, but unfortunately, those rules helped improve the playability of future titles. So now, asking me to go through all of the time and anxiety needed to get through this game, it's a grueling journey with little reward. Tomb Raider is easily my least favorite game that I've played so far in the series. It's the one that's aged the worst, the one I was the happiest to see finished, and the one that I have no intention of ever revisiting again. So yeah, that's one PlayStation down. Now time to tackle the PlayStation 2. Which I'm also going to play on the PlayStation 3. I have 13 supporters on Patreon, including Brianne Shaw and Haley's mom. But 13's such an unlucky number. So perhaps you should join and fix that. You can watch these episodes 3 days early, help decide future episodes, and even have access to bonus content. Or if you just want to watch from afar, you can follow me on Twitter. You can also leave a comment on what game you'd like to see in a future episode. No guarantees, but why not? And you can also like the video and subscribe and click that notification bell to find out about future episodes. My next episode will look at one of the more bizarre games to come out on the PlayStation 2. So until then, thank you so much for watching.